Hi, I'm Sandra, and I used to be Avril Lavigne's hairstylist.
Hi, I'm Mr. Sheffield, and I was Avril's grade 6, 7, and 8 teacher.
I'm David Remington, mayor of the town of Greater Napanee.
My name's Dan Jones.
My name's Mike Sewell.
Avril Lavigne was our babysitter.
My name is Bill Gosmopoulos. I'm the owner of La Pizzeria, Avril Lavigne's favorite pizza place.
My name is Steve Mehta. I'm an associate and friend of Avril Lavigne. I wrote a song specifically for Avril called Touch the Sky, and that was, as it turned out, the first song ever written and recorded by Avril. On my shoulders and back. It was February 1999, and I remember she walked up to the mic in the studio and she just nailed this take flawlessly. First track ever in her life in the studio, and she just put down a perfect track. Our jaws just dropped and we looked at each other speechless. And as we left the studio, I remember Avril turned to her dad and me, and she said, you know, this is one of the most memorable moments of my life. It was a pretty special moment.
What was the very first song you ever wrote about?
It was called Can't Stop Thinking About You. It was one of those cheesy little
love songs.
Yeah.
We knew that she would somehow take this and take it further in her life. I don't know if any of us realize how swiftly she would make success.
I remember I met you a year ago before all this stuff started, and was this what you were expecting, it to be this big and everything?
Probably not this big, no.
I don't think anybody could have predicted her fame, but she certainly was a special kid in that she was very determined. She was very focused for someone her age.
I heard that you started writing when you were only 12 years old.
Yeah, that's basically when I was 12. I just picked up the guitar and I started like writing lines, and then basically I would say that I wrote my first like full song in the correct order, like verse, chorus, verse, bridge, like when I was 14.
Wow.
Avril's father encouraged Avril to practice. And anytime I'd go there and I could hear her singing down in the basement sort of thing.
My parents wouldn't let me on the phone.
Oh no.
And like they like wouldn't let me go out on the weekends and or like stay after school and hang with my friends because I had to come home and practice. So.
Oh man.
I've had the opportunity to meet her parents. You can see where Avril gets it from. I mean, they're just very committed people. They're just a really nice family.
There was certainly a lot of encouragement by Avril's family to, you know, to really make something of the singing.
I had to practice and rehearse all the time. And it was kind of a bummer, but I mean, it's all worth it.
Are you aware of what you make me feel, baby? Right now I feel invisible to you, like I'm much radio. Didn't you feel me lock my arms around you? Why'd you turn away? Here's what I have to say.
Avril wrote Losing Grip about an ex-boyfriend who didn't give her what she needed emotionally, but as she says, at least she got a good song out of it.
I mean, it's like tough being on the road and stuff. Like, I don't get to see my friends or my family very much, and I miss my dog. But I mean, I got my band, and like, they're my best friends.
How are you doing with just boys? You're just around boys all the time. Your band is all boys. How are you doing with that?
It's fine. I mean, I have a girl out on the road with me that, you know, just kind of is there for support or whatever and just kind of helps me out. But I don't mind just, you know, basically being the only girl.
At school, she was always hanging out with the boys and stuff like that. But she was, you know, she had a bit of edge to her. She was a little tougher than most of the girls her age.
I heard you refer to yourself as a tomboy. What does that mean if you're a tomboy?
I meant like I used to be a hardcore tomboy. I mean, I still kind of am, I guess.
Avril played all kinds of sports. She was always fast, and she ran like a gazelle, and she was always the one that was first to the ball.
When I was younger, I always hung out with guys and played all the sports with guys, went hunting, camping, fishing, all that stuff.
She played hockey in the community, and played for the Napanee Minor Hockey Association. She played with the boys because there was not a girls' league in Napanee.
She might have been the only girl that I can remember that has taken recreation technology, and again, I think probably because a lot of girls didn't at the time skateboard as much.
I'm not into the whole like girly thing, like oh my heels and my nails.
Me
and all
neither,
that
me
stuff.
Neither. You look like you have some muscles.
I do, but I don't work out.
You must do something. Look at, I don't have anything. And you have
I play guitar
muscle.
And I beat up guys all day.
Nice. But in a playful way, ladies and gentlemen. Playful way.